A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John, chapter 8, verses 31 to 42. Passage taken from the Message version of the Bible. Then Jesus turned to the Jews who had claimed to believe in him. If you stick with this, living out what I tell you, you are my disciples for sure. Then you will experience for yourselves the truth, and the truth will set you free. Surprised, they said, "But we're descendants of Abraham. We've never been slaves to anyone. How can you say the truth will free you?" Jesus said, "I tell you most solemnly that anyone who chooses a life of sin is trapped in a dead-end life and is in fact a slave. A slave is a transient who can't come and go at will. The son, though, has an established position, the run of the house. So if the son sets you free, you are free through and through. I know you are Abraham's descendants, but I also know that you are trying to kill me because my message hasn't yet penetrated your thick skulls. I'm talking about things I have seen while keeping company with the Father, and you just go on doing what you have heard from your father." They were indignant. "Our father is Abraham," Jesus said. "If you were Abraham's children, you would have been doing the things Abraham did. And yet, here you are trying to kill me, a man who has spoken to you the truth he got straight from God. Abraham never did that sort of thing. You proceed in repeating the works of your father." They said, "We're not bastards. We have a legitimate father, the one and only God." "If God were your father," said Jesus, "you would love me, for I came from God and arrived here. I didn't come on my own. He sent me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Reflections on the Gospel according to John, chapter 8, verses 31 to 42. Faith is not real until it touches our attitudes and, above all, our concrete choices. To remain in the Word of Christ means to conform our lives to His life and His virtues. Christ seems to imply that there are true and false disciples. There is only one way to tell the difference between the two. Whether one embraces his word not only as an ideal, but also as a rule of life. The false security that the Jews claim on the grounds of being descended from Abraham could find its parallel in us Christians who are content with our baptism and our religious practices. We come across traditional Catholics who say, "We have been Catholics for many generations, and we grew up in strong Catholic traditions." And ironically, we fight for defending our traditions while leaving the Word of God stranded on the streets. Perhaps in our earnest efforts to remain faithful to the centuries-old traditions, we have missed the point. We forgot to remain with the Word. We have become Christians not because of any of our merits. We go to church every day or every week, not because we are better than others. We are also chained by sin, but we believe in the Lord who forgives and sets us free. If we continue to love, every Christian is on a mission to forgive and love. "I have been forgiven, I will forgive, and I will be an instrument of reconciliation." This should be our attitude. A person who has wounds can understand with empathy the wounds of those around him. A person who acknowledges and owns up his or her failures can better accompany people with all their weaknesses without being judgmental. My own weaknesses and failures helps me to put aside my ego and instead give Jesus, who can set us free, the center stage. Pope Francis tells us that the knowledge that we are wounded sets us free. Yes, it sets us free from being self-referential and thinking of ourselves as superior. The people with whom we interact and live do not expect us to be superheroes. They expect us to be companions with all the weaknesses and limitations. Wounded soldiers become bolder. Wounded Christians become more loving. We say yes to the Lord at the start of the day and every moment of our lives. Sinful yet loving, wounded yet willing to serve.